top 5 Excel features. Number 2, the SUMIF function. SUMIF is a function that can extract useful information from big data sets almost immediately. If you have a large number of data rows with different associated parameters, you probably want to know information about data concerning only a certain parameter. Take this example. I have a small table telling me how many units of various items I have sold and which department sold them. It's easy for me to see the total sold by all departments, but let's say I only want to know what the UK departments achieved. I'll create a quick left formula for a new column that looks at the left two characters of the department names, and so we'll pull out UK for all the ones that start with those characters. Now I'll make a SUMIF that looks at my new column, which will be the first argument, cares only about the rows with UK in this column, which is my second argument, and finally sums the sales for each row that meets my condition, which I do by selecting the sales information as the third argument. As long as the department and its sales data are on the same row, this is all I need to create a UK department's total. Incidentally, I can also make an overseas total by creating the same SUMIF, but with the criteria for summing being that my new column isn't UK, which is indicated by putting a less than and greater than sign together in front of the letters. So there you go, in just a few seconds I've extracted some handy information from my data. Not much time saved in cases like this where there are only a few entries, but in the case where there are hundreds or thousands of records, this technique is really going to help. Of course, it's also very versatile. I could come up with any number of different summing conditions. I can even have multiple conditions at once by using the very similar function, SUMIFS. To use it, I select my sum range first, then I alternate between ranges to assess and what criteria to choose, which means I can actually create very complicated summing conditions, especially if some of my assessed ranges contain the results of other formulae. For example, let's say I want to know the sum of sales from shirts from Denmark. I can make another column of my data, this time an if function that says if the description contains the word shirt, return a 1, if not, return a 0. To do this, I need to employ two other functions. First, I use search, looking for the word shirts in my target cell. If it finds the word, it returns a number, the character position of where the word starts. If it didn't find it, no number is returned. So I can use an isNumber function to tell me if the word was found or not. That function returns true or false, so I don't need to specify a true condition for the if function further to this. Now I'll make a SUMIFS function that sums the units sold, with my first criteria range being the left two characters of the column, taking cases where it's equal to DE for Denmark, then my second criteria range being my new if column, taking cases where it's equal to 1. Now I've got my specialist total calculated for me, which again in a giant dataset would be far easier than manually formatting the data to make it possible to work it out for yourself. An extremely useful little technique, but if you want to know about something even more useful, continue on to the final video in this series. Otherwise, to get more tips and tutorials on Excel, Access or VBA, subscribe to this channel or visit software-matters.co.uk and check out our helpful articles.